He was officiating and trying to fix the point spread. This story broke in today's edition of the New York Post. Law enforcement officials claim that Donaghy made bets involving thousands of dollars during 05-06 when he worked 68 games, and last season when he worked 63. He also officiated 20 playoff games over the past two seasons.
Tim Donaghy, outside official, made the call late, and he's telling Mike D'Antoni to get back. Now, what happens a lot on this, the official along the baseline, in this instance, Greg Willard, was right there, but sometimes, it's what officials call, you get eaten up on the play. You're so close, you may not see it. Donaghy perhaps giving Willard a chance to make the call. He didn't, but it didn't look like there was much there.
No, I don't know what he saw. Tim Donaghy making the call from half court.
Bowen on Nash. Nash to Stoudemire, gets passed inside block. Picked up by Parker. Duncan just so poor to D'Antoni getting a workout. He's not upset at that call. He's upset at the non-call down the other end.
Well, let's see if Duncan gets it. I mean, that's a foul.
Yeah.
He reaches right over the cross of his shoulder.
Well, the left hand, too, John.
Left
hand,
and with, yeah, left hand.
And Kurt Thomas tracks down the rebound. Offensive foul, Stoudemire. That's his fourth. Stoudemire can't believe it.
Mike, I got to tell you, I just don't like that call. Stoudemire just running down the floor, trying to set up post position, and a guy stops in his way, right side of your screen here. I mean, that is, you can't make that call in the NBA playoffs, Mike. I'm sorry.
It was certainly a flop. Duncan, and a blocking foul called on Nash. That'll be his third.
Wow, I'd like to see that one again. Steve Nash with great weak side help. Pick and roll, Tim Duncan dives to the lane, and Nash, let's see if he got over there in time. Well, you know what, that looked pretty good, but I don't know. What do you think, Mr. Official, Mike?
That's very close. It looks like he may have been there. You don't have to have your feet set as long as you're in the position and the offensive player initially
got to take that shot.
It's unlike a Barry to pass that up.
Absolutely.
Foul on Diaw, trying to help out. That's his third. Second team foul. Stoudemire will sit for a while with his four fouls. Barbosa comes in.
Like Tim Duncan might have shot the right hip out there a little bit on Boris, but we know he's not going to get his fourth call on that.
D'Antonio lead. A foul. Nash is hurt. Mike D'Antoni screaming at Ed Rush. And they call the foul on Bowen. That's his first. Nash shaken up on the play.
Mike D'Antoni is incensed. Bruce Bowen with a knee to the groin.
That's what D'Antoni's upset about.
He thought that was an intentional play. Now let's see.
Ooh,
wow. I'll tell you, right to the thigh. probably gone off the window for 20 of those.
Nash trying to get it past Bullock. Nash yelling, calling for a foul. You rarely see him that upset. And a technical foul call against Mike D'Antoni. D'Antoni hot. He saw his leader, Steve Nash. And Nash usually doesn't react that way unless he really was hit.
You're right, Mike. That's a great move by Mike D'Antoni to protect his best player. You know, players love that when your coach comes to your rescue.
Although at this point in the game, every point counts. You don't want to pick up a technical.
Well, it's okay. Maybe you can get this team going. They're floundering right now.
No, we're being told that the technical was actually on Dan D'Antoni, the assistant coach and Mike's brother. I want to make a correction. They did give Mike D'Antoni that technical. Obviously, Dan much better behaved than his brother.
Again, booting for a foul.
Steve Nash again complaining about getting hit here. Look,
that's a foul.
You know, Robert Horry hit him on the arm.
Eddie F. Rush looking right at the play.